What's happening, guys? Safety Liner C2 here. We've got bus stuff for sale. Everything is just some stuff that I've found on Craigslist. I'll try not to focus on any one thing for too long so that we can get a handful of things in here. And yeah, two things. Don't forget that if you have something that you want to submit for bus stuff for sale or lots of lots, throw it in the video request form in the description. And second off, none of these postings are mine. None of these pictures are mine. I don't claim responsibility for any of that stuff. Just throwing it out there. Yeah, let's go ahead and get straight into this first one. All right, let's start off in Omaha with this 2000 Bluebird International for $4,800. First off, we can see that this is a high headroom bus. There is a little bit of rust on there, but it doesn't look like it's in terrible shape overall. Here's the driver's side of the bus. It's a handy and has a lift in the back. Again, it doesn't look to be in terrible shape. Here's just a different view of the front and a different view of the back. Also, I just noticed on the back, check out the stripes on there. I've always been a fan of that, and I'm glad to see that it's made it over to an older Bluebird. All of the seats were cleared out inside. There's overhead storage, which is a nice touch. Just a standard Bluebird driver's area of this era. The control panel, 247,000 miles. There's the tread, the engine, and the manuals. The description says that it's in overall good condition, that it has a remanufactured DT-466, an automatic Allison transmission, and that both the motor and trans were replaced by the previous owner and have less than 50,000 miles. The odometer stopped at 250,000, but the current drivetrain is low miles and in good shape. It is going to need some brake work soon, apparently, but it starts up, drives, and stops. 4,800 is a little too much, and that's probably going to be turned into a schoolie eventually. All right, now we move to New Caney, Texas, where we're taking a look at this Carpenter Ford that was converted into a schoolie. Unfortunately, it doesn't run, but it's also being sold for $900. It's in pretty rough condition, as you can see, and my guess is that it was never turned on again once it was parked there. Here's a look inside of the passenger side. There's the driver's side. The back of the bus, which still has a seat in it. There's a better view of that seat. And just a little area right there. My guess is that it's ultimately going to be scrapped. Let's move west a little bit to San Antonio and take a look at a 1986 Superior International. The description says that the previous owner began to convert it into a schoolie, that it's missing a window in the back, it needs a new battery and fuel pump, the tires probably need to be replaced, and it has an International 345 gas engine. Here's a look at the bus. The poster said that the last time it ran was 8 months ago, so it'll probably take a little bit of work to start up, but it looks like it might just need some love here. Here's a look at the passenger side of the bus. Aside from the missing hood latch, it looks to be fine. Here's a look at the back of the bus, and I want to say that there's turn signals missing here, or an extra brake light that would be in the middle here, but I'm only seeing this one hole, and maybe one or two right here, so I don't know if it's missing them or not. If it's not missing those lights, then this is very unusual, and I can't say I've seen one spec'd like this. Also take note of the strobe light up at the top. Here's the driver's side of the bus looking forward. You can see a little bit of rust up top, a little bit down below, but again, doesn't look to be in terrible condition. Here's the driver's area inside, and a look at the body of the bus. Again, I think this just might need some love. So for $3,000, if it runs, that would be great. It is missing the seats, so that's kind of a setback. I don't know, it just really depends on a lot of stuff there. I'd say I'm on the fence about this one, but I would want to get that. All right, we're moving to Waco, Texas to take a look at a 1982 Wayne International powered by propane. As you might be able to tell from the picture, it was converted into a schoolie. This is a look at the side of the bus. We have the dual wheelchair doors. There's the back of the bus and the inside of the bus. $5,500 for a bus of that size might be a little too much, but it is a propane bus, and the poster said that they just ordered new tires to put on it. I definitely know a few people who would want this bus, though. All right, we're in Palm Springs, California now, taking a look at a 1995 Thomas B700. There are a handful of these, but they all have the 5.9 Cummins engine, Allison transmissions, handicap door and lifts, and anywhere from 200,000 to 275,000 miles at $6,500. So first off, like I said, you can see there is a lift, and you can see a couple others in the background, as well as a jackknife door on a Thomas. The tires look to be in fair condition. There's a look at the Cummins, a better look at the tires. All the seats are in there, and plenty of space for wheelchair students. Also notice the emergency door on the back driver's side. There's a view of the lift, the driver's area, and the driver's side of the bus. I know California only requires the back stop sign, But doesn't that just seem way too far back? I understand that if they put it in front of the emergency door, it would be too far up, and that they probably should put it where the e-door is, but still. Take a look at this. Here is a ramp for the wheelchair students on the back emergency exit. That's not an option that you see too often. And there's the ramp fully extended, and just a different view of it. I can see this going to a schoolie like a lot of the other ones, especially because of the ramp in the back. This would be great for someone who wants to bring along like a motorcycle or something big like that, but this definitely is a very uniquely specced bus. We'll take a look at one more. It's a 1999 Amtrak RE in Big Fork, Montana. It has 260,000 miles, air ride, air brakes, and understorage, along with a DT 530. Here's a look at the bus. Doesn't look too bad. And the back of the bus. The driver's area is looking really good for its age. Also notice a push-button transmission. And yet again, the interior looks extraordinarily clean for its age. Despite all of that, $8,500 is pretty high. All right, so we'll go ahead and end it there. And as always, let me know in the comments below which one of these you would buy if money wasn't a problem. I would have to say it's either between that Thomas B700 or the Amtrak RE. Reasons being because the Thomas B700 is just uniquely specced, but the Amtrak RE has a DT 530, which is not something that you see too often. All right, like I said at the beginning of the video, if you have anything that you want to submit for Lots of Lots or Bust Up for Sale, throw it in the video request form in the description of any of my videos, and I will get around to taking a look at it. So anyway, guys, that is going to do it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Always do appreciate it. Make sure you subscribe right down here. It's a magical red button that says you are now subscribed to Safety Liner C2. Make sure you comment up here, down here, over here, or over here. I don't know where they put it down and care where they put it. Make sure you also give this video a thumbs up, or all the DT530s are just going to cease to exist. And make sure you also share this video with a friend, show it to your mom, share it to your dad, show it to a guy on a random street. I don't care, don't let anything happen to you. So yeah, guys, that's going to do it for this video, and thanks for watching.